we are changing our venue from West Winds Primary Health Center to Saskatoon City Hospital, and we're extending our hours. So we are now going to offer the clinic on Saturday from 9 till 4 so that we can meet the demand that we are receiving by phone. So this is a much better site to move people through quicker. If we do have lineups, then we've got a warm venue for people to wait until we're able to provide them with their vaccine. Saskatoon City Hospital is also a great location because it's quiet here over the weekend, and we are offering free parking as well, so that shouldn't deter people from coming here on Saturday to see us. Humboldt is also offering some vaccines, so that would be for our rural residents on Friday, so tomorrow from 4 till 5 o'clock.
There's sentence in here saying people who previously made immunization appointments for next week will be contacted and asked to come to the Mass Immunization Clinic instead. So what happened with their appointments?
So what we have been advised by the ministry is that we need to distribute the vaccine day by day. And so that means that on Saturday we are anticipating that we will use all the vaccine based on the anticipated demand. So we are wanting to notify those individuals that had booked an appointment that we may not have vaccine available for them next week. So we will be phoning to advise them of that so that they have opportunity to come in on Saturday and don't not come in on Saturday and then anticipate there would be vaccine available for them and then we have nothing to offer them. The ministry will be conferring with us on Monday and we will across the province be looking at what our supply is and then from there trying to determine what more clinics that we can offer to make the vaccine available. But until Monday, we won't have any further opportunities for people other than on Saturday.
Are you planning to get any more vaccine that we talked about Monday?
The ministry right now is working at securing some more supplies, but until they advise us, we are going on the assumption that what we've got is the vaccine that we have. And then we'll be sharing that information with them on Monday, and then from there another plan will be developed in terms of how it can be dispersed so that it's fair across the province.
Is there a concern about running out of vaccine?
Well, the province is trying to secure more vaccine, and across Canada, we know that the demand is there from Alberta and BC. And so every year, there's only so much vaccine that's manufactured to meet demand, and because of this year is a bit unique in that the demand was a bit greater than we had anticipated, the ministry is looking to try and obtain more vaccine than what they have currently in their stores.
Are you anticipating that all 1,500 doses will be given out on Saturday?
That's what we are anticipating based on the phone calls that we're getting, and we're definitely staffed for that. So we have enough nurses that would be able to administer that in the time frame that we have allotted for the clinic to move people through as quickly as possible.
How many nurses will be on hand?
We'll have about 20 nurses on hand, so there'll be 15 at any one time immunizing. So they're pretty swift at getting people through the clinic, so they can immunize about 12 people, 12 to 15 in an hour.
What is the largest number that have ever been vaccinated in a day, like say when the clinics open in fall and they're hosted at Prairieland Park?
Prairieland, we did a maximum of 3,800, so quite a bit more than what we're anticipating on Saturday. But we have also done quite a bit of immunizing. We've done 56,000 of the public, and if we add in all of our staff, we're up into the 65,000 range. So there are people now that are just starting to trickle in, and so we're finishing up, so to speak.
Have we reached the peak of the season?
We don't know for sure. I would say that given last year and our surveillance, that we still are monitoring and we're still seeing an increase in terms of the number of cases, and will for the next week or two. That's very typical. Right now we have seen 116 cases of influenza, all influenza A, none B, and that is very typical of what we saw last year. In terms of hospitalizations, very typical of what we saw last year as well. What is a bit unique is that those that are being diagnosed, lab confirmed with influenza, are those that are 29 to 50. So typically what we see is children that are ill and hospitalized and those that are older, 70 and above. And for this year, we're seeing people sort of in that middle age group.
You had mentioned that you're going to call those with appointments next week to see if they can come Saturday. I know maybe sometimes people book appointments because their schedules aren't that flexible that they can just come to a drop-in. So for those who will start, because I can see the complaints start rolling in, What are you guys going to do for those people?
Well, what we need to advise them is that we're being directed to use our vaccine day by day to ensure that it's spread out across the province, so that at this point, we need to do that very thing. And so we're advising them that they need to come in on Saturday.
So just to clarify, it's not 1,500 that you have left. It's 1,500 that you're going to give out on Saturday?
Well, that's about how much we anticipate we will have left as of the end, as of Saturday when we open up the clinic.
How many are available right now?
Well, this week so far we've given about 2,000 doses out, which is about double what we normally would give in a week. So what we're experiencing is people that have booked appointments like our well baby clinics. Parents are also opting for immunizations and their siblings. So our demand has increased this week. So we've basically doubled the amount of vaccine that we have been given.
Maybe you can give us some insight into why you think the demand has kind of gone up so high. Is it the kind of H1N1 scare that's happening in Alberta? Why do you think there's such demand or such an influx of demand?
I think that's one of the reasons, is because they're seeing Alberta and BC with higher cases and now are thinking, well, gee, I can prevent this. Why would I expose myself to being sick when I know that I can have this vaccine? And so sometimes it takes a while for people to have the right motivator to decide that this is the right time for them, and maybe this is a more convenient time than in the fall when we did offer our main clinics.
You know, what would your message be to the public who are concerned about, you know, not being able to get a vaccination if they can't make it to Saturday's clinic? You know, what's the message to the public about the level of vaccinations that is available right now?
Well, I think what we need to remind people is that immunization is the best protection. But there are other ways to protect ourselves from respiratory infections. So great hand washing and coughing into your sleeve and really good cleaning. So doorknobs, keyboards, all of those kinds of things is really important to prevent the spread of influenza. And that's what I would be encouraging them to do if they're not able to get the vaccine.
Should the public be worried about the amount of doses that are available?
Well, I think that's up to them in terms of if they're going to be worried or not. I mean, we did have clinics all fall to offer to them, so that I would say their secondary option is to use other strategies to reduce their risk of influenza and stay home when they're sick and try and protect themselves from people that are sick if they are worried, if somebody that's close to them has a respiratory infection.
Is there any sort of prioritization of who will be getting these kind of remaining shots in regards to older people or younger people or anything like that?
That's a good question, because we know that children under 5, pregnant women, those over 65, and people with chronic conditions are more at risk. And so that will be a determining factor perhaps next week when we are looking at how much vaccine we have and do we need to prioritize the remaining doses depending on how much we get. But at this point, up till Saturday, we are providing that vaccine to anyone that is wishing for it.
The people that you just listed that are more at risk, none of them were in that age group that seemed to be contracting H1N1 this year. So how do you actually determine that? Because you were saying a lot of the people getting H1N1 are in that middle age, but yet the people who are recommended to get the shot are seniors, children, and pregnant people.
Right. So, for example, up right now we've done over 5,000 kids that are under 4. That's quite a few children. So I think because we tend to encourage children to be immunized and people over 65, that they have some protection, and that's why maybe they have some protection and aren't getting sick. Typically, people that are in that other category are healthy adults and are assuming that maybe they can fight the flu and aren't getting the vaccine. I don't know what the actual reason is for them in terms of why they chose not to be immunized, but what we're seeing is that particular age group.
Right, but so then I guess my question is, like he was saying, how will it be prioritized? And you said it'll be prioritized by the young need it, the old need it, and the pregnant need it, but yet it's that middle age group that seems to be contracting the virus. So then it seems like everyone needs it. Maybe crazy, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, now I understand what you're asking.
Okay.
Yes. So the NACI or the national guidelines still are that children, older people, and people with chronic conditions absolutely need the vaccine. So the other thing that I don't know and I can't tell you is of that middle age group, how many of those clients had a chronic condition? So often those age groups also have a medical condition, diabetes, heart disease, something like that, and then they contract influenza, and that then causes more challenges for them in terms of fighting off influenza, and then often they develop pneumonia as a secondary infection.
Okay.
Yeah.
There are a few pharmacists in the province pushing to be able to give out immunizations. What does the Saskatoon Health Region think of that, or is that something you guys can talk about?
The ministry has asked us to direct that type of inquiry right directly to them.
Do you know how many cases of H1N1 are being analyzed a day? Like, how many patients are kind of presenting with H1N1 on a daily basis, or how many patients are being found to have H1N1 in the lab? I know about a week ago it was around 10 cases a day. Has that increased as well?
No, I think that's about right. That's how many we're sort of seeing.
And all of the influenza, you said it's influenza A, and that's the H1N1, right?
The predominant one strain is H1N1, which I think is really important to remind people that if they did have the seasonal influenza vaccine in the fall, that vaccine did have the strain of H1N1 and H3N2. And then it has an influenza B, but we haven't seen any influenza B disease so far. So that's really important because people are phoning in asking now for an H1N1 shot, and they don't need it if they had their seasonal influenza. It's just those that didn't come into the clinics in the fall.
So is the Saskatoon Health Region expecting a bit of a mad dash on Saturday for this last?
Absolutely, we are waiting for a mad dash, but I think we have our ducks in a row, and I'm confident that we'll be able to move people through the template. We're used to doing that in a mass clinic. We know how to manage our mass clinic. We've got a great facility here. People will be warm if we have to have a lineup, so I think this is the best facility to offer that type of service.
And how do you find the therapies gym here? The walk-in with the treatment, where they go?
The people that we have
come in on Saturday into the treatment, where else should they go?
Oh, they don't offer service on the weekend in the therapist gym. So that enabled us to use that gym.
He's asking where it is.
Where is the?
Oh,
clinic?
I'm sorry. Yes, the therapist gym is on the main floor, and it's just off to the left.
By the information
it's
desk.
By the information desk. Okay. Yeah. So we do have volunteers here to assist people as they come in the door and get into the template. It's a little bit of a jaunt to get there, but we will help get people to where they need to be and get them out as quickly as possible.
Can I just grab your whole name and address?
Yes.